head, and you just can't stop hearing it, the words. Well, to a child of the 60s, lyrics impact a socially conscious spirit, and that spirit is sitting right next to me.
Oh, thank
Aimee
you.
Holtzman.
Thank you.
From Rock and Roll, 501c3,
yep.
Which helps people, but also is a think tank because you're always
Coming up with ideas. We're always talking to people and looking at new ways to do what's really important, get food to people who need it.
And you do that. Now, you grew up in Toronto, and your dad was a physician. Do you think that is maybe what also helped you in the vein that you want to help other people?
Yeah, I would say so.
My you haven't dad, thought of that, right?
I really haven't.
You're thinking about that.
You know, I kind of get chills when I think about my dad.
Okay,
because,
okay, let's talk about him.
He was really an interesting kind of guy. He was always helping all kinds of people and always involved in community and giving back.
That's you, Aimee.
Thanks. And he was always, you know, it would come dinner time and you never knew who was going to come into the house with him or who would show up. Yeah, it was really, really interesting.
Oh, that's so great.
And he got involved in a lot of people. I mean, they could be his patients that were in a bad way. And he was really involved in the art community, so there could be some very famous
artists sitting
at the table as well. So that explains
you. And then you went to Detroit, and then after that, you went to Arizona, where you met the love of your life.
I did.
And you married.
Well, you know, like I said, and I've said many times, I left Detroit kicking and screaming. I did not want to leave. My life was there. My friends were there. I was going to school with my girlfriends. I finished high school. And my parents said you could stay or you could go, which is like, you can stay or
stay
you can go.
Go.
Should I stay or should I go?
You can start singing, you know
but,
this.
But I decided I would stay, and they said, no, you're going to go. And it wasn't really a trip I wanted to make or a place I wanted to go, but the most wonderful thing in the world was waiting
right.
for me there.
Right.
Little did I know. So I kind of lived my life like that. It was a big turning point because we're all on a journey.
Exactly.
And we
right.
don't know what lays ahead.
You're absolutely right. What a great thing that they had and encouraged you and they said you're going.
No, they dragged me.
They dragged you. Kicking and
there
screaming.
There was no encouragement.
Kicking
there was
and
dragging.
Screaming.
Kicking and screaming. Kicking
well, I have a video screaming. Right now which is going to explain a little bit about Rock and Roll, the 501c3, and then we're going to talk about specifics. So let's take a look at this
Thanks.
Video, shall we?
I love those kids.
Aww.
Why not feed the people everywhere and let the peace begin? Turn your swords to plowshares everywhere and feed the people.
And rock and roll is not just about, you know, a can of food. It's about the act of doing something. And everybody can do something.
My name is Trevor. I'm the kitchen manager at the Border Mission Kitchen. But these stuff, this, your name is?
Aimee.
Aimee. Aimee has given us for the past 2 weeks, months.
Well, this stuff, for the past couple
so
weeks.
So much for these people that is in need in the Rockaways, Staten Island, Brooklyn, even around here in New York City. It helps so much. I appreciate that.
It's so our pleasure.
You know, from the party to you. Thank you. What a gift.
Hey, this is Devin Allman from the band Royal Southern Brotherhood. Rock Can Roll is such a fantastic idea. It's very simple. You bring non-perishable food items like canned goods and dry foods to concerts and know that you're helping out hungry homeless Americans. These goods go right from the concerts to the local food shelters. You can help out while you rock out. Check out rockcanroll.org to learn more.
You know, when you saw this, I was just so delighted. You were speaking to you. It's like you never had seen it before because you're reliving all those wonderful memories from celebrities that we saw to the everyday person to the children and to the man who was thanking you for all that food.
Yeah.
What is your reaction after seeing this?
You know, hunger and poverty are tough issues that most people prefer to ignore.
True.
And rock and roll is changing that. And I look at that video, and none of those people knew about rock and roll.
Right.
And we're changing it. And we're a voice, and we're an advocate, and can get up there on a soapbox and say, you know, everybody can do something.
And nobody should go hungry.
And people should not go to sleep at night without food to eat, or worrying if they have food to eat. And all those people in that video that you just showed, before they knew it, I mean, we all know it, but now they know it.
But now we know it. Now something's being done.
They did something about it. You know, I looked at the pictures, like with the picture of Warren Haynes.
Right.
That picture, I crack up every time I see it. First of all, the nicest guy in the world. And that picture, we must have taken it 15 times.
Aww.
And if you go back and look at it, on the clock behind him, it's 9:05.
And then what's the
last 9:10. And the concert was supposed to start at 9.
Okay.
And here he is backstage taking the time to take a picture with me while he's got thousands of people waiting for him.
Stage.
But, you know, his taking that picture is letting me talk to you about it and anybody who will listen. And
the generosity of him,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, but they say, you know, a picture can say 1,000 things. But a picture like that can help me feed 1,000 people.
Absolutely.
Because he took the time to care and do it right.
Now, where can somebody see this video? What is your website and how do they reach
you? It's rockcanroll.org. And it's a YouTube video. I think that one, we've got that up on YouTube somewhere. And if you can't find it, you can find
and
me
they can
on Twitter,
contact
and I'll direct you. I'll redirect you to where it is.
Let's talk about some of the celebrities, and I think anybody who's helping in this case, you, everybody who contributes, celebrities.
You.
So let's talk about Brett Michaels.
Yeah.
Let's talk about some of the people. Share with me some of that, if you will. I mean, here you are. You know, I have to say, Nassau County, PTA, mom of two very talented musical young man we'll talk about in a moment. And you're now in this celebrity world.
Yeah, I don't get it. Why me?
And why not you? Why not you, I ask.
I have to tell you, every time any of these people, whether it's Crosby, Stills, and Nash, or Brett Michaels, or Maroon 5, or Warren Haynes, or whoever they are, you know, whenever they take the time to meet me, I'm just in awe, and all I can say is thank you. But the bottom line is they're regular people like me and
like
you.
Everybody.
You know,
like everybody else.
Who's might be watching this. They're regular people. And they do what they do. They're musicians, they're artists, they're performers. And they can't do what I do. They can't go schlep food, organize this, do that, the other thing. But they can help. And taking the time, like I said, to take a picture, make a video,
Devin, to help out, to use his celebrity in a way to help other people.
Few words.
Melissa Etheridge, tell me about her.
The nicest. Mm. You know, she autographed a guitar for us. I mean, she didn't have to do that.
Lisa Lampanelli. Because we see her in one way on TV.
She is. Oh, don't let that fool you. She's fabulous. She is absolutely wonderful. And you know how amazing this woman is? I had the honor to meet her at the theater at Westbury years ago when she was doing a show there. And we met in the lobby. We took a picture. And afterwards, I realized the picture didn't come out. But I saw her a year and a half later at an event. And at the theater, she was great. And a year and a half later, I saw her at an event for St. Jude, and she was the headliner. And I was able to go up to her after. I said, "Hi, you know, I'm sure you don't remember me."
She said,
"Of course, you're from that rock and roll thing
at Westbury." Look, I got chills. That's fabulous.
I was like, "Are you kidding me?"
But you see, that's the impact that you have on people too.
That she remembered
well,
me. I'm telling you, took my breath away. Aww. And we took another picture, but I think I had to like get the tears off my face.
It was more shock and awe,
you know, that she remembered me and
Lily
she took
Tomlin
the table.
Too.
Could you believe that?
Yeah, I mean, these are just so.
Have you seen her new show?
I have heard of
Frankie
about
and
it. Yeah, I have heard of
whatever.
It.
My kids turned me on to I love that show.
She loves it. Yeah.
And I need her clothes. Just in case she ever happens to see this, I need to know who is
look
getting,
in that camera
I need
and
to
tell
know who is getting her those clothes because she's
you
fabulous.
Love the way that you
oh,
that's
the
so
best.
Funny.
But she is the nicest. And her foundation, she also donated, they donated $5,000
really?
To organizations.
Okay,
yeah.
So people can donate money. People can bring cans. We're talking about you making appearances at schools, at the Paramount, which is just 30 feet away from us right here in Huntington. We're talking about going to organizations. They just need to bring a can.
We're talking about everybody can do something. That's
everybody
what we're talking
can
about.
Do
That's
something.
That's what we're talking
I love
about.
That.
And everybody's busy and they don't always know how. So
that's it.
That's what rock and roll is all about, is we say, what are you doing in your life? And how can we bring rock and roll into your life and make giving part of it? And we do all the hard stuff. We just
and you say,
try to keep it simple.
Help out. While
you rock out.
Rock out.
Yeah.
And that's your motto, which I love. You do all of the work. You get them organized. You collect all of it. Then you bring it. You have to do all of that. And you have so many wonderful volunteers.
Amazing,
you
right?
You saw the kids in the picture.
Kids.
You saw the man who was thankful that he was getting that.
The Bowery
which,
Mission. That was
which got
just...
to me because someone saying thank you, that you care enough, that you're going to help them.
Yeah.
Let's see a quick video. Can we... Maroon 5, Adam.
The two of them. And Jesse. They're delicious.
Absolutely.
Hello, everybody. This is Maroon 5, and we're playing a show coming up at Jones Beach, and we urge you guys to bring all canned foods that you may want to donate to Rock Can Roll.
Indeed.
Rock Can Roll.
Indeed.
Cans.
Indeed.
Don't bring bottles. Don't bring fabrics. Mm-hmm. Don't bring... Don't bring like pastries,
mm-hmm. unless
they're canned pastries. But I've never heard of that before. Mm-hmm. But yes, rock can indeed roll. Rock can roll. Bring cans of stuff and give them to people that need it.
Yeah, this is a great charity. Awesome. Check out rockcanroll.org for more information about it. And please bring anything you can out to Jones Beach on August 11th. And this charity works with a lot of other concerts too. So check out their website and see what other concerts you can bring cans to, and we can help put a dent in hunger.
I'm going to get a can of whoop ass right now.
All right. Woo!
This is just great. And I know that your sons are also very involved musically.
They are.
You have to say something about them.
All right.
let me twist your arm, Mom.
Well, if I have to. No, I'm like incredibly blessed. I have an amazing husband. He's a neurosurgeon who... just is so supportive of what I do. We have these two fabulous boys that my husband thought, oh, great, I've got boys. We can go play basketball and baseball and teams and football
right,
and
right.
sports. So Alex, our older one, is a singer-songwriter. his most joyful day was when my husband took him to a baseball game, to see the Mets, and he couldn't believe someone sings the national anthem. He was like, how do I get to do that? And actually, I think it might have been Idina Menzel, that year, who sang it. And then he thought the seventh inning stretch, if it couldn't get better that you could sing the national anthem, that everybody sings Take Me Out to the Ball Game, that the seventh inning stretch was
that's,
the coolest.
That was it for him.
So that was it. That's life with Alex.
Oh, that's funny.
He and then went on to NYU, and he's got a a composer and
there's
philosophy
minor.
There's
the music influence.
Yeah, and he's
got
a record out. He's got a couple of records out, and he's finishing up another one, and he's out in L.A. now.
And Ben?
Because that's where you belong. Uh-huh. And Ben, my little guy, again, my husband's Alex
see,
is
this
like,
time. We'll get
we
back
got it
to,
now.
Let's get to that but, baseball
yeah,
game.
No, Ben, Ben. Ben is a music. Went to Syracuse studying musical theater. He was always in local theater here on Long Island. He went to the Performing Arts High School
Isn't
in Manhattan.
That something.
And he put to, actually I didn't, he put together an a cappella group that is called Range A Cappella. That he got it together. He did this at school, and after the first video came out, a couple weeks later, they got an email from ETV. Inviting them, saying,
impressive.
We saw your stuff. We'd
my
like
goodness.
You to come out to California for the Oscars.
Wow.
And they, and within 10 days, we got them tuxedos, gowns, contracts, airline tickets, an apartment.
Look at that. It's amazing.
A hotel, you know, for 10 of them. And they performed on the red carpet at ETV.
I think that is just incredible.
But wait, there's more.
Oh, okay. Okay, because I want to get
so
one
great.
More thing.
If you thought that was great.
I do.
He put together another video recently, a mashup of Kelly Clarkson, called The Evolution of Kelly Clarkson. Ben is currently, I should say, in Macau, China, with Disney, traveling around the world for the next year as LeFou in Beauty and the
Beast. That's why you have that phone ready.
Yeah,
you're
like,
waiting
whenever
for that
my phone
call.
I keep looking
rings,
at my clock.
You're
because
jumping. There. Yeah,
the phone rings,
phone.
And I look at my watch to see what time it is in China. But
that's
so
wonderful.
He's there. He put this video out, The Evolution of Kelly Clarkson. Kelly Clarkson saw it, and last Friday, the Range a cappella performed at Radio City Music Hall with Kelly Clarkson.
Beautiful.
So
how proud you have to be.
I'll tell
be.
You the funniest thing, and then I'll stop. But he was in China, and I can't believe we did this, and I'll probably get arrested for it. But
uh-oh.
I had him on FaceTime on my shoulder,
right.
And he was able to watch from Macau his friends on stage at Radio City Music Hall.
That is
it
amazing.
Was real. I mean, it's so mind-boggling that you could do that.
That you are able to do
that.
You
could even like
to even think to do that.
That I could do it. That anybody could do it. But I could do
but
it.
But that you could do it. But Aimee, very quickly about volunteers.
That's my gift.
Just tell me
yeah.
a little bit more about the volunteers and how people can help you and volunteer.
So
very quick. I need to get that information.
Our volunteers are, like I said, everybody can do something. Volunteering is part of that. Our volunteers.
And meet this wonderful lady, really.
And we just have, you know, I'm just looking for people. Tonight we'll be Neil Young. So I'm looking for people with a heart of gold to come out and just help us out. We're at shows, we're at concerts, we have a really good time, and we're really able to stand on that soapbox and be a voice and advocate for those who need
favorite
it.
Favorite lyric from a song that would.
So many.
Teach the children well, maybe?
Yeah, teach your children.
Maybe that would be a good
Nash.
Motto for you?
I don't know. Alvin Lee singing, I'd love to change the world,
love
and I don't know what to do.
Okay.
Cat Stevens, I'm on the road to find out. I mean, he was forever
see, the
in
lyrics
my heart,
parents
you know?
Do influence our
yeah,
kids. I
yeah.
want to thank you so
oh,
much. I know that you have to get going to Jones Beach to do this.
And,
Thank you. Always wonderful to see you.
You're wonderful.
This is Rock and Roll.
Rockandroll.org.
Thank you.
And
thank you.
For all your home or office cleaning needs, who can you call in our community? Our reputation is spotless. Teresa's Family Cleaning. We treat your house just like it's our own. We clean Long Island, your business or home. So pick up the phone.
What's that number?
516 we clean or 631 got dust.
Teresa's Family Cleaning is the name you trust. Our reputation is spotless. Teresa's Family Cleaning.
Welcome to
Thank
the
you.
Show. I'm so excited about this. Now, you were 15 years old, and one of your heroes was Elton John, and another was Billy Joel.
Yeah.
There you are, Miller Place High School.
Miller Place High School, yeah.
Did you ever think in a million years that not only would you get to meet your idol, but you'd actually be playing with him?
Never in a million years.
Never, never.
No. When you start out, you always have dreams, and you have these things in your head, and you hope I can get to here or get to there, but you don't ever think it will actually happen. So,
well, let's go back, because you have a lot of your own original songs, and then I believe that you had seen some people doing tribute songs.
Right.
Who was it that you had seen do that? And now you have four children, and
yeah,
it's time to get involved with it, right?
Yeah. I had to pick up the speed with the money thing, and I was doing piano bar for a long time, so it was okay, it just wasn't enough. So I think I had seen the band Ants Marching. They were at a Dave Matthews tribute band.
Dave Matthews.
And
okay.
I was like, wait a second, you know?
I could do that.
I've been doing Billy Joel anyway for the last whatever. I think I'll do a Billy band, and that's kind of how it originated.
And then you ended up, what, in Port Jefferson at the pub to year 2000?
Port Wind, yeah, Port Wind Restaurant.
Port Wind?
I played there for a couple of years.
I think I remember that.
my uncle Nick at the time was managing me, and he had a friend at Port Wind Restaurant, and got me my first gig there. So.
MLK's?
Yeah,
everybody knows you. You say that name, and
MLK's
that's what it
is. MLK's is our Nassau home base.
All right, so let's share the actual story, because I know Billy Joel was not on tour, and you've worked with some of the guys.
Yeah.
So let's bring us back, because we are in Huntington,
yeah,
and we're 30 feet away from the Paramount.
Yes.
Let's talk about that story, because it's such a beautiful dream to have lived and to be able to share.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, being that we're right next to the Paramount, it's perfect. The Paramount was the first place that I actually got to do the rehearsals for Billy Joel, and then actually meet Billy, you know, officially. And then did the first gig with Billy at the Paramount. So we're 8 feet away from that. So basically, I had all the guys in the band. They were playing with Big Shot and over the years. And Billy had needed somebody. We were thinking about going back on tour again to London or England or something like that. So there was rumor that something might happen. And Tommy Burns, guitar player, came up to me and said, hey, listen, you know, Billy doesn't always like to rehearse. You go, how would you feel about doing the stand-in thing? You know, stand in for him. Stunt double, they called it.
Stunt double.
Billy's stunt
double.
Billy's
stunt double.
So I said, I'd love to do that. That'd be great, you know. So I didn't hear anything for a month. And then Tommy came up to me at a Oyster Bay show, and he said, listen, they're doing that thing. Do you want to do it? I said, absolutely, I would love to do it.
Were you a little nervous at all?
Yeah, I was excited, really, just to
more
do that.
Excited,
you know,
than
I mean,
most of the guys
that I was going to be playing with have been playing for me. So,
it
was a real natural
progression.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. But till Billy walked in the room. But that was a different story. Then it was,
Yeah,
and then it was a little bit
And I understand that he has heard you play, and he thought it was his own music.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's extraordinary, isn't it? I mean, that's incredible.
Yeah, I mean, you know, when you do a tribute band or you do somebody else's music, you always hope that you do it justice, and I'm really thankful that he thought of it that way.
Well, let's see what he has to say about it, shall we?
Okay.
This video?
Sure.
Of his band, the new guy, Mike DelGuidice.
This guy's in a Billy Joel tribute band called Big Shot. We had Big Shot do a sound check for us once. So I go backstage while they're doing this, and I'm hearing this guy singing. I said to one of the road crew, oh, they're playing a tape. No, that's that band Big Shot. I said, no, it's not. I know my voice. That's me. That's a tape. Then it was this guy singing. He plays guitar, he plays keyboards, sings harmony great. It's almost as if I'm harmonizing with myself. I asked him to be in the band, and I'm having a good time watching him, seeing what's going on, because he just did a quantum leap.
Wow. Oh,
well, when you put it together that way, it's a very,
beautiful?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I see you looking down.
I couldn't help smiling. It was like,
smiling,
wow.
You're looking up. You're so modest. Wow. But it's got to be great.
Yeah.
And let's talk about this, because this has changed your life. You are traveling all over the place.
Yeah.
Brings you away from the family at times.
Actually, not that much.
No?
Not that much. No. I mean, I think with Billy's schedule, the way he's doing it now, it's not a demanding tour, you know? We go in on a Friday, we do a gig on a Saturday, we fly home on a Sunday, and then we don't gig again for another...
Unless you go to the United Kingdom.
Right, yeah. Well, that was different. My first tour with him, we were away for 2 weeks.
Right.
So that was amazing. That was a little rough, and a lot of anxiety before that.
What did your kids say about this?
Everybody was really blown away.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it was a really exciting time when it happened. Yeah, you're 2 years down the road, and it's like, now it's work. You know, now I got to make sure I show up every day, I do my job, do what I got to do. But the initial shock of it wore off, and now it's every night we play, it's just, let me do the best I can so I can keep doing this.
Do you come from a musical family?
Not in my immediate family, although my father was probably could have been a bass, really good bass player. If my mother didn't look at him with the guitar in his hand and say, that's not going to help pay the bills.
Really?
So,
okay.
I'm not sure if she had anything to do with that or not.
But I was encouraged
by both my parents. They were really, really supportive. I got to say that. We didn't have a lot, you know, growing up, but we had a lot of that. So they were very supportive. They knew I loved guitar and drums early on, and they never stopped me. So I think that's the main thing. You know, it's not like they were saying, Mike, you should really do this.
Right.
It was just they were never saying don't.
They wouldn't say no. Isn't that wonderful?
Never say don't. That's a beautiful thing, a gift
that you can give your children. I guess you give
like,
that
Dad,
to
Dad, listen
yours.
To this. That's great. That sounds awesome.
Aww.
And without the comment after of, yeah, but son, you know, maybe you think you should get a real job.
No,
never
did
that. Or
from
my mother.
Wonderful.
Or from my mother, yeah.
Now, I know that you're also helping stamp out cancer.
Yeah.
So you want to talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it seems like these days everybody on Long Island has got something going on, and there's a lot of friends. So we did a show for a boy named Kyle Martin in Miller Place. Miller Place is where I went to school, so it was a natural thing to do.
Isn't it incredible to go back to it?
To go back to my school.
Your daughter is there.
Yeah, all my kids go to Miller Place.
How about if we take a look at a clip with one of the most beautiful songs ever, Hallelujah.
Oh,
with
great.
Your daughter.
Oh, excellent,
and I'm
going
to try not to cry when we watch this, because when I saw this, I was just so moved. And I want to know about you when you watch this clip and relive that moment with your daughter singing.
Absolutely.
That had to be spectacular.
Okay.
Please.
Well, I heard there was a secret chord David played, and please the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? But it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. show that told me, do you know? Remember when I moved in you, holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you for having me so much.
Come on, one more time, guys, would you please? Samantha DelGuidice.
That's my baby.
What's going through your mind right now?
Oh, it's such tough to watch. You know, it's like, not tough to watch, it's just
it's
really.
It's so beautiful.
Yeah.
How emotional are you right now?
A lot. Yeah.
Very emotional. Look in the camera. What would you like to tell her?
Oh, well, you just blew me away again, like you always do, and I love you. That was beautiful.
Oh, how talented is she?
Yeah.
Anybody else in the family, too?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, my mother, my father, my brothers, my kids, I mean, my
both
my
sing?
Yeah, everybody.
So if I come to your house, well, I'm going to hear all the singing.
Yeah, my son, both my sons have really good rhythm. One of them sings real. Everybody can carry a tune. Everybody's got
That's fabulous.
So it's definitely a musical and boppy household.
Oh, for sure. That's fabulous. That's excellent. Now you're going to be appearing at the Paramount August 8th. Tell
August
us about
8th.
That.
Yeah, we're starting to run. For this fall, and I'm really happy to be back here. We played a show a couple of years ago here, and then we did this with Big Shot, and then we did a stuff here with Billy. So to come back now and to make this our Suffolk, there's going to be like our Suffolk residency, basically.
Oh, that's fair. We're so happy to have you. Yeah, here. I'm going to get to see more of you.
Yeah,
too.
You definitely
how
will.
Exciting.
And
it's so
great to be in the town. Because it reminds me of that day when it all happened.
Exactly right. That's why it's going to be a good feeling.
Yeah, it's a good vibe. So.
Now, what are you doing for us today? I'm really thrilled. I'm going to mosey on off this area. I heard Josie. Tell me about the two songs.
Yeah, well, Josie's, it's my mom. So I wrote the song about my mom. And my mom had a rough childhood, 10 kids in the house. She was the oldest girl. So you can imagine she took care of a lot of kids when she was younger. That's how it was back then.
Where'd
it was
she
like,
grow up?
I think she grew up in Hicksville.
Okay, Long Island.
Yeah, on Long Island. Yep, Long Island, and went to school there. Mm. And she had a tough going.
So this is something in her.
This was something like, you know, we all view her as, you know, your mom's nuts. She's crazy, and funny, crazy
she's
too.
Fun.
But yeah. But
you have to be with that many kids, right?
Yeah, I would imagine. And you know, parenting, you could tell wasn't as easy for her, and she was figuring stuff out.
Right.
And we didn't have it very easy either with her, because she just was still getting all that together. So this is my ode to her, and me understanding now being a parent. I got what you were going through. Yeah, sure.
How many times did we say, "I hope you have a child"? Just
yeah.
And what's the second song?
Second song is called "Until the End."
Until the end.
It was written after my first divorce, and me, like Billy, we've had quite a few. The two of us, but
we're not going to go there.
Four children, and just amazing kids, and it's really about the pain of divorce and me
powerful,
writing.
Powerful,
yeah,
very powerful.
Yeah.
When do you get your inspiration to write these songs?
Well, they kind of come as they come. This was, you know,
is it
like
in the middle
said,
of the night? Is it just you driving?
It can happen anytime.
Do you immediately start to write the words?
Yeah, I mean, it depends. Some songs, words come first sometimes, and then other times it's just a hook line you get in your head or a chord. I have a chord progression that I have a melody for that I love, and you know, and I go from there. So a lot of times it's different. Until the End is one of those songs, few in my writing career, which has gone on now for 25 years, where I could say I wrote it all basically in one shot. It was down, write it from start to finish.
I know you had to be a musician. I get that. But if it weren't that, what other field would you have done?
I would imagine it would be some kind of something. Yeah, maybe acting, maybe
something in the arts.
Yeah.
It had to be.
Or something more humanitarian related. So
fabulous.
either you know, I don't know, I want to say hospital work or some kind of, you know,
something
doctor
humanitarian.
Or something, something, yeah, teaching, any kind of thing like that. I always found.
Well, I'm going to move you on out and let you do your thing.
Thank you so much. All right.
Josie was born in a Long Island town, north of the Long Island Sound. Forced into motherhood before her time, Josie could never be found. Hiding in the closet with a tiny tear, listens to the sound of music coming up the stairs. And when she sits at home at night, she cries. Josie, what's the method to your madness? Josie, have you told them of your pain? Maybe one day you can put it all behind you. Nothing they could say would change my mind. You're an angel in my eyes. Josie met Fred and they ran away to wed sometime in the spring of 63. Fred fixes motor cars, Josie complains, bearing the pain of the stains. Hiding in a bedroom all day long in fear, she listens to the sound of children crying in her hair. And when she sits at home at night, she whines. Josie, what's the method to your madness? Josie, have you told them of your pain? Maybe one day you can put it all behind you. Nothing they could say would change my mind. You're an angel in my eyes. Sitting at the PC playing solitaire, Fred sits at the desk and pays the bills that took his hair. And when they sit at home at night, they whine. Josie, what's the method to your madness? Josie, have you told them of your pain? Maybe one day you can put it all behind you. Nothing they could say would change my mind. You're an angel in my eyes.
You have grown and I have shown.
always be around until the end, my faithful friend, till the I'll always